Hello friends, welcome to my channel. This channel is all about to clear your small doubts in regarding facts, science and innovations in this big world. Today the topic is which is the bird has a shock absorber. Do you want to know the bird which has shock absorber? Watch this video to know about that. Come, let us go into the video. Before that, all of you please subscribe my channel. Woodpecker is a bird that always pecks on trees for food to attract its mate and to build its nest. It pecks continuously for 5 or 6 hours. Nothing happens to its pecking on even hard cysts of trees. There is a portion on the head of woodpecker resembling the shock absorber fixed in vehicles. It is a sponge-like substance found at the joint of beak and skull. This portion receives the backward push when it pecks forcefully on tree trunks. No damage thus occurs to the brain of bird. Moreover, the skull moves a little backward at the time of each peck. It is this high-quality shock absorber that protects its skull even though the woodpecker pecks at the trees continuously and forcefully throughout its life. Woodpeckers are part of the family Picidae that also includes the Picillates, Rhynchex, and Sapsuckers. Members of this family are found worldwide except for Australia, New Guinea, New Zealand, Madagascar, and the extreme polar regions. Most species live in forests or woodland habitats, although a few species are known that live in treeless areas such as rocky hillsides and deserts. And the Gila woodpecker specializes in exploiting cacti. Woodpeckers range from tiny picillates measuring no more than 7 cm in length and weighing 7 grams to large woodpeckers which can be more than 50 cm in length. The largest surviving species is the Great Slaty Woodpecker, which weighs 360 to 563 grams, but probably the extinct Imperial Woodpecker and Ivory-billed Woodpecker were both larger. What are the habitat requirements of woodpecker? Overall, woodpeckers are arboreal birds of wooded habitats. They reach their greatest diversity in tropical rainforests, but occur in almost all suitable habitats including woodlands, savannas, scrublands, and bamboo forests. Even grasslands and deserts have been colonized by various species. These habitats are more easily occupied where a small number of trees exist, or in the case of desert species like the Gila woodpecker. Tall cacti are available for nesting, some are specialists and are associated with coniferous or deciduous woodland or even, like the acorn woodpecker, with individual tree genera, oaks in this case. Naturalists are able to adapt to forest clearance by exploiting secondary growth plantations, orchards and parks. In general, forest-dwelling species need rotting or dead wood on which to forage. How is the behavior of woodpecker? The majority of woodpeckers live solitary lives, but the spectrum of behavior ranges from highly antisocial species that are aggressive towards their own kind to species that live in groups. Solitary species will defend such feeding resources as a termite colony or fruit leather tree, driving away other conspecifics and returning frequently until the resource is exhausted. Aggressive behaviors include bill pointing and jabbing, head shaking, wing flicking, chasing, drumming and vocalizations. Ritual actions do not usually result in contact and birds may freeze for a while before they resume their dispute. The color patches may be flouted and in some instances, these antagonistic behaviors resemble courtship rituals. What they use does feed. The majority of woodpecker species live up to their name and feed on insects and other invertebrates living under bark and in wood, but overall the family is characterized by its dietary flexibility. With many species being both highly omnivorous and opportunistic, the diet includes ants, termites, beetles and their larvae, caterpillars, spiders, other arthropods, bird eggs, nestlings, small rodents, lizards, fruit, nuts and sap. Many insects and their grubs are taken from living in dead trees by excavation. The bird may hear sounds from inside the timber indicating where it will be productive to create a hole, crustaceans. Mollusks and carrion may be eaten by some species including the great spotted woodpecker, and bird feeders are visited for suet and domestic scraps. How they breed? A pair will work together to help build the nest, incubate the eggs and release their outer visual young. However, In most species, the male does most of the nest excavation and takes the night shift while incubating the eggs. A clutch will usually consist of 2 to 5 round white eggs. Since these birds are cavity nesters, their eggs do not need to be camouflaged, and the white color helps the parents to see them in dim light. The eggs are incubated for about 11 to 14 days before they hatch. If you like this video, then like, share, subscribe and comment the video.